We're back this year doing a Christmas carol. Oh my God. It's pretty, isn't it? I'm in the house. I'm gonna show you a little backstage tour of Christmas Carol 2.0. Anyone in here? Hope you're not naked. I don't wanna get canceled. We're making our trek down the hallway. Backstage, there's the scene shop, like you guys haven't seen this before. Let's see, what the hell's back here? Let's see, we have a music stand for offstage singer. There's no microphone, so there's probably no offstage singing. So last year, if you remember, Patrick was the Ghost Christmas Present. He's doing, I think, the tour of Margaritaville, so he can't be here this year. They changed the face of the Ghost of Christmas Present to reflect our new Christmas Present. Here's creepy Tiny Tim. Look at him. Looks like fucking Chucky. So we have today's run, tomorrow's run, and then Thursday's Thanks Fucking Giving. And then Friday, we open. We have a 2 o'clock preview, and then I think 8 o'clock. Not much has changed in the music. We've added some stuff. We've changed some of the blocking. There's some new dancing. We have a terrifying ladder that people have to climb. This is Megan, she's our Hello. Costume extraordinaire. What are you working on?
I am very quickly hemming someone's skirt before they go on. This has a beautiful ruffle at the bottom. So if you have like a skirt that has really pretty trim at the bottom, you don't wanna lose that trim when you go to hem it. So what I'm doing is I'm folding it up and hiding. You can see I'm hiding like a little pleat right under, like in the middle of the ruffle, so the audience would never see it, and then the skirt is shorter, so the actress isn't tripping. I started doing costumes when I was a freshman in high school, and I had an awesome theater teacher who was like, you're good at this, and I was like, thanks, I really like to do this, and I never got away.
You have a YouTube channel too, right?
I do, check me out.
You want to plug it?
Megan Grace DIY, if you want to learn all sorts of fun sewing stuff.
Well, I'll let you get back to work. Have fun. I am vlogging! Christmas Carol 2.0! Oh, yeah. Remember? She was Silly Girl, right?
Yes, I was.
Beauty and the Beast, that vlog.
I was the one who fell down 2 years quite ago. Often.
Megan, what are you doing in the show?
I am a madrigal, and then I am the understudy for Christmas Past. I'm looking at myself and not at the camera. Understudy for Christmas Past and Mrs. Dilber.
Yes. Do you like it so far?
I sure do. I get to fly. It's real fun.
Yes, she does. She's the one, she goes on that ladder that I said was creepy earlier.
Yes.
It's a creepy ladder.
Yeah. So are you late to vocal warm-ups? Because of...
Is this vocal warm-up?
Your vlog?
Oh, Carl's late. Wait, what time's vocal warm-up?
6:30.
No one told me. Vocal warm-up! I have no idea!
Kevin, you're
we did it at 6:45 yesterday. Vocal warm-up! So I'm gonna trip on that. Oh my God, I don't want to trip on the lights. Let's see. What are you doing this year?
This year, I am the assistant stage manager and the COVID safety officer, and I am now the deck chief as well.
Wow, how is it? Because last year you had to do stage managing and COVID stuff, right?
Mm-hmm.
So now it's two separate things?
Yes, now it's its own actual job according to equity rules.
Wow, what's that like? Is that like a permanent thing?
Yes, you have to get a certificate. I am qualified.
I did not know that.
It's a $50 certificate.
A new layer of protection in live theater. There's our Scrooge. Up here, we have a projection of the clock. You know, when the clock starts 12, it does its thing and starts freaking out. This is where Scrooge comes in and out, as does the ghost, some of the ghosts, some of the other stuff. It's a stage door. Look, you gotta hang light up there to make it look freaking terrifying. It looks fun. They're using QLab. It's like industry standard software. Almost every fucking Broadway show uses QLab to run the show. But it looks like they got a lot of shortcuts. Go button, next cue, back, next pause, panic, stops the cue. And they have headphones back here. So that way, stage manager calls the show. She says, okay, get ready for sound cue number 3, go. And then they press the button when she says go. You have the wig for Ghost of Christmas Present. And then we have fire hazards everywhere, you know, carpets with wires running under them, you know. Then we have props table. Now remember, don't touch a prop unless it's yours. So we're not touching, we're just looking. We got a hat, jingle bells. Ooh, they got a violin. Finally. Oh God, this fucking music is gonna haunt me. So bring us some fucking pudding. Look how detailed the props are. Like they actually have a ledger. This is gonna haunt me for the rest of my life. This is the pre-show music. I have to leave. I'm gonna have to hear this for 3 weeks. I'm not dealing with it. It's Leah!
Hi!
Are you ready for the show?
I am. I'm so excited.
Who are you playing?
I'm playing Mrs. Dilber, also known from Carl as Mrs. Dibbler. But I think that's a character on Full House, too.
And you also do Christmas
Past. Happy holidays, everyone.
I know. Christmas Carol 2.0. Break legs, Leah. Well, see, she's also a professor here. And she teaches dance, she teaches yoga, she teaches movement for actors, she teaches voice. She teaches a lot. So she teaches during the day and does the show at night. So she's got like full-time crazy schedule going on. Carl too, he's playing Scrooge. Workplaces. So look, you have stage manager, lighting designer, and then a bunch of other people. I don't know what they do.
All right guys, come get your masks.
We have to do piano and harpsichord. Here we go.
His burial was signed by the clergyman, the clerk, the undertaker, the chief mourner, Ebenezer Scrooge.
Sole mourner.
Sole mourner.
Sole executor, sole friend, sole administrator, partner assigned, and residuary legatee.